Heaven sent you to me. I'm just hoping I don't repeat history. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. For those of you that are new here, welcome. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video if you like. Today I will be discussing hair, skincare, and makeup products that I find are useful to my everyday life. Some of them are new, some of them are old, some of them you are familiar with, and some of them you're not familiar with. So I'm just gonna get right into the video. And by the way, I'm not wearing a rug. I got this pretty cool shirt at Rainbow. I think it was like $10 or something. I mean, anyway, I'm rambling. Let's get to it. So I want to get into more of my skincare products. Now, for those of you that don't know, I suffer from really bad acne scarring. So I have like these little ice pick dots. You can't really see it, but you see I have some breakout. I didn't really like understand. I kept thinking that makeup was just going to cover all my imperfections and all my insecurities, and it wasn't. Skincare is very, very important. So the first product and brand I would like to talk about is CeraVe. So I'm going to show you guys what they look like this. So, oops. So let's say you're someone that wears makeup every day and you're just always out and you're wearing makeup. I would recommend using this one. This is the Foaming Facial Cleanser, and I love this because when I first started using this product, my face was bad. I had breakouts, pre-active breakouts, scars, wounds, you name it. I had it all over my forehead, underneath my chin. Like, it was just so bad. And for some reason, I had it really bad right here. And I was getting it on my ears. Oh, I used this and I bought all of these products because I really wanted to know for myself if they work, they truly worked. And this really saved my face. Like, you know, now this one, I'm not too fond of it because it feels like more of a cream consistency, whereas this is more of a foaming gel. So with this, I don't really feel like it was getting enough dirt. In the beginning, I would use both, but I always tend to favor this one. I always tend to go for this one. So I only use this if, let's say, I wasn't wearing makeup and I went in and washed my face with this and I woke up the next morning. I would then go in with this facial cleanser because it still protects the skin barrier. Like, I do not want to strip my face from its natural oils. So this is for someone that has more of like dry skin, because I feel like it's more hydrating, if that makes any sense. And for the moisturizer, in the beginning I wasn't really too fond of it because it didn't have a thick buttery consistency, which is something I'm used to with moisturizers, and I like that in moisturizers. I mean that's just me. I don't know if you guys like that, but I like to feel like my face is getting moisturized. So I noticed that when I just put this on, it's good. The first time I used this, I used one full pump. You don't really need one full pump. A half a pump of this is good for your whole face and neck. So what I do is, step by step, is I'll use either or of the facial cleansers. And then I would pat dry my face, towel dry my face, and then I would go in with the CeraVe Hydrating Hyaluronic Acid Serum. And I love this stuff. This is amazing. So I noticed when I put this on first and then this, it just gives me a nice moisturizing feeling. Like, I feel like my face is and my skin is hydrated all over again. I didn't lose anything, like any of the natural oils in my face. I feel like it regained the skin barrier. So I have to give all of the CeraVe products from this line a thumbs up because it really worked for me. One of their products that I went and picked up, I use this. This is the eye repair cream. And I mean, when I wear makeup, I could see a huge significant difference, but I can't really say. I can't really say that this is not working. My whole skin, it just looks so much better because I've been treating it, taking care of it, and makeup just looks so much better when you're applying it to good skin. Moving on, I want to talk about sometimes if, like, let's say I'm just all over the place and I can't get a hold of my face wash because it's in the closet in the bathroom, I'll go in and I'll grab this just because it's so much easier. Like, if I can't find one, I'll use the other. I want to pick this up because I forgot how great this product was. I used to use this back in my dancing days, and I believe they have a foaming body wash with the same, like, it looks like the same consistency, but I use it for my body and it used to work wonders. They used to take acne off my back. And this is the Soap and Glory Vitamin C Facial Wash. So it looks like this. This is a travel size. They carry bigger bottles and bigger packages than that. They have a bunch of other skincare products from their line, as well as bath products. And I believe, I don't think they sell makeup, but yeah. Another thing I used for the past 2 months was this tea tree spot solution. And I'm not crazy about it. I don't know if it worked. It's supposed to reduce redness and prevent active breakouts. So I just don't like that the consistency is like runny. It just feels like watery mint water. I want to talk about the Ole Henriksen Truth Serum. This is the vitamin C serum, and I ran out. And this was a product that I was trying out for the first time. Now, this has collagen, which is something I need because I suffer from, like I said, craters, and it kind of looks like ice pick scarring. And this helps, you know, balancing out the skin barrier and just plumping the skin back up. This little bottle has lasted me 5 months, and this little bottle, I think, cost me about $15, $20. I got this on Mercari, or I think it was Poshmark. I'm not sure, but this was the best investment I've ever made. I really enjoyed this product. If you pair this with any of the Tatcha skincare products, even better. I kind of want to invest in one of these things. I've had this. This is the Clarisonic MIA Mia and Mia Prima. So it looks like this. You can get different brushes at like Sephora. You can order them online. I never charge mine, so like mine's just so dead. But what I do is, after I'm done washing my face and I've applied my serum, I go on with this just so that I know that my skin is sucking in all that good stuff. So for face primers, I went back to an old school method that I used to do, and I was using it so wrong. I was doing this method so wrong. So now that I started using it again, I want to talk about it. For the past 4 years, when I wear makeup, even now, the lighting is picking it up from the camera. I look like I have a dewy face, right? Wrong. All the makeup that I use today is matte. Everything that I've used on my face is matte, except for the highlighter. But everything up until the setting spray is matte. I was having trouble. Once again, I'm still trying to heal my skin, and I still would like to wear makeup sometimes without my skin looking so textured. So I tried so many primers, and I felt like some of the primers I was using were leaving my face a little too greasy, or leaving the foundation or product, whatever formula I had on my face, it was sliding off. And I live in Florida. It's always hot over here. So I had to think of another alternative that was something a little bit within my price range and something that I could afford. So I went old school, baby. This is the Philips Milk of Magnesia. Now, if you know, you know. If you don't know, then this is used. Some makeup artists use this, and it comes with a cup. I can't find it. But what I do is I pour in a little cup very lightly, and after I'm done moisturizing my face, I would take a brush and I would dip it into the product, shake it well, and then I would just go over my face. And what this does is it absorbs all the oil in your face. So it works as a primer, and it protects the skin from any makeup seeping through. So what I do is I put this first before applying any of my foundation, concealer. I do that once in a blue. I don't recommend you using this if you have dry skin, because this is just going to dry your skin out even more. This is for people that have really oily skin and just want that really matte effect on their face. Now, I changed my foundations. And I say foundations because I think this is a foundation. Oh, this might be a concealer. Oh, well, I don't know. So I went to Ulta, and I did not buy this at Ulta, but when I went to Ulta, I picked up, for some reason, I don't know if Ulta sells Milani foundation, but I know they sell Milani concealer. So don't shoot me. Okay, so what I'm using now is the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation and Concealer. I didn't even know that. And I'm in the color Sand Beige, which is 06. And I'm telling you, one pump of this gives me full coverage. Full coverage. It just, it's the best thing. I love this. I love this foundation as much as I love my Estee Lauder one. Like, they should be friends. I'm gonna put them together. Anyway, I love them. Same way I love this concealer, the Milani Conceal and Perfect. I had no idea. Like I said, I picked up the concealer at Ulta and I bought the foundation at CVS. So I had no idea that I just was grabbing two products that are from the same line, whatever. But the Conceal and Perfect, I am in the color medium beige, which is 135. And it's just, even this concealer works even on breakouts that you're trying to cover underneath your foundation. Great, great stuff. So happy. A new product that I want to talk about that I purchased. I was skeptical about buying it, but I don't know, like after purchasing this, I really want to invest more in their products because I was blown away. This is the Juvia's, I want to say, concealer, because it looks like a concealer but it could be a foundation. So I use this. This is not my skin tone, this is a 12, and I use this for contouring. So what I do is I take this out and then I just put a line here, put a line here, go over here underneath my jawline. And what I do with this is I take a damp beauty blender and then I just, remember, you want to push it in. So I just push it in, blend it out, and then I go in with the Essence Sun Club Matte Bronzing Powder. And this is in the shade Better Than Vacation Tan. So it looks like this. Hi, me. I really like this. I love it for setting my contour. It's just amazing. And speaking of setting, I moved so ahead that I skipped like all three of my primers, but that's okay. So I went back to this old product that I used to use. This is from Rimmel Stay Matte. This is the translucent powder. And how I use this is I take a brush, I swirl it, and then I just press it in. And then after I'm done pressing that, I go in and I press my entire face. And I love it because it just blends perfectly in with my skin. It, once again, it's translucent. And then I go back in with the CoverGirl True Blend Mineral Powder. And this is translucent as well. And then I just apply that on top. And I know you're going to kill me. But then I go back in with the Revolution Banana Deep Powder. And then I layer that underneath my eyes to bake. And while that's baking, I go in with my eyebrows. Speaking of eyebrows, I want to talk to you guys about the Anastasia Brow Brush. It's the number 12. This is a good brush to have. Even if you run out of the Anastasia pomade, you can always get your hands on some cheap, affordable pomade eyebrow, tint at any local pharmacy. So yeah, that's just a little good investment. It's one of my favorite brushes. And so far right now, this IT Cosmetic brush, this is the concealer brush, and this has become one of my new favorite brushes. I use this to conceal underneath my eye or any acne spots that I want to get rid of before applying my foundation. Now, as for Revolution, I already showed you guys that I use the deep under eye powder, setting powder. I also have the I Love Revolution Heartbreaker concealer. This is just an extra concealer that I have around. I actually bought this because I really liked the packaging. It's like a heart-shaped top, and then the little spoolie thing is like a heart shape too. So it's so cute. And it's a really good concealer. I love Revolution Cosmetics. Speaking of, I also have, I think this is from one of their lines. I'm not sure the name of it. It looks pretty funky and groovy, but this is the brow gel. and this is in the color ash brown. I don't really like more of a deeper color because I do have blondes and I kind of like the ashy brow look. Plus, I could just always go back in with my pomade just to enhance things a bit. And for setting sprays, right now I alternate between three. So let me just show you. I'm using the LA Girl, four. Hold on, Poles. Totally forgot about my baby. So this is my favorite setting powder. Setting spray. This is from Becca. This is Skin Love. And it has more like of a watery, cucumbery smell. It just leaves you so mystifully smelling amazing. It's infused with glow nectar and it's just the best. Like when you use this, you kind of want to shake it up. It has like this iridescent glitter inside. And the bottle's holographic too. I love this stuff. One of my other finishing sprays is from LA Girl. This is the Shimmer Spray. And I think this has a little bit of gold glitter in it as well. Of course, the Mario Badescu. I use the cucumber one. I kind of want to go pick up the lavender one. I don't know. I'm not a big fan of rose fragrance or coconut fragrance. So, I don't know. I'm very iffy about smells. And then last but not least, the Revolution Matte Fix. So, these are more like dewy spray settings. Setting sprays. This is the only matte one that I have. So far so good. No problems. So, I want to talk to you about three last products for today. And yeah. So, this is the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer, and I've already used this twice. Love it, and I pair it with my baby skin. I do this first and then do this. It just, once again, it gives me that extra coverage. It prevents anything from seeping into my pores, and that's what I want. I don't see anything wrong with being extra careful and extra protective when it comes to your skin. So, for example, we always put double foundation when we want full coverage. Well, why can't we just double up on, you know, like the good stuff, you know? So I double up on primer. And another primer that I picked up, which I haven't tried because I just feel like it's going to give me more of a dewy look. This doesn't give me that dewy look. It gives me like a mattifying. This is the Luminous Putty Primer. And this is from e.l.f. And it's matte, but it has more of a bronze, a shimmer to it. You can't really see it, but they seem fragrance free because I don't smell anything. And for mascaras, my holy grail, the Sensational. I love this mascara. I just can't seem to like get rid of it. I can't seem to not stop using it. I always grab this one. When in doubt, this. It gives you length, curve, volume. It's buildable and people will sit there and ask you and question you if those are really your lashes. I love this. But it's a B word to get off. It's such a B word to get off. Hold on. And the Ulta Maximum Lashes. It's something about mascaras. When I use them for the first time, let me be careful. I never get excited to use a new mascara because it's just, the first couple of uses aren't really the greatest, and I've been working on that. So after a few tries of this baby, the Ulta Beauty Mascara Maximum Lashes Defining and Lengthening Mascara, I like this stuff. I grabbed it because obviously they show you in display what the bristles look like, and I kind of like my mascara bristles to look like this. I feel like they're more evenly coated because I have thicker lashes. So if you're someone that has thick lashes, that might be a product that would work best for you. Miracle Leave-In product. I got this at Ulta. I used to use the deep conditioner mask, and I don't know. I just stopped using it because I found other masks right here, which I'm going to be talking to you about. But when I don't know if you guys noticed, but my ends are blonde. So I do tend to have some breakage, and I kind of want to grow my hair back out as healthy as possible. So I did trim my hair because I'm starting over, and there's nothing wrong with starting over. So to help restore my split ends, I go in after a shower, after I wash and condition my hair. If I'm going to air dry, perfect. If I'm going to blow dry, perfect. I do not I try not to blow dry my hair because I want my natural curls to come back. So I just spray a little bit of this, and I'm telling you, your hair is going to smell and feel so amazing. Like, I love that the fragrance stays in your hair for like 3 days. So this I picked up at my local, these products I picked up at my local beauty supply store. This is the Do Grow Mega Thick Hair Formula. So like right now my hair is in a bun, and I like to do this at least twice a week just to ensure that my hair is not losing any oil and it's getting all the nourishment it needs to grow and get back to the way it used to be. So I'll go in and put a little bit of this on my ends and then massage it through my scalp and leave my hair oily. So tomorrow will be day two, and I will go back in with this remedy that I have. So it's just a bunch of different oils to help your hair grow. Another product that I went and picked up, which I had no idea helped and stimulates hair growth, is the Eco Style Plex Olive Oil Shea Butter Black Castor Oil and Flaxseed Oil Hair Gel. And I did not know, not only does it smell good, oh, it just smells like a luxurious cologne, like the inside of a nice new leather car. That's what it smells like. I didn't know it had like these little glitter thingies. There's little pieces of gold in there. It looks like 14 karat gold. Like, who don't want 14 karat gold in their hair, you know? And I love that it doesn't leave any flakes. Whew. As you can see, it has a nice hold. And when I take my hair out, it leaves my hair so soft. It doesn't have that crunchy, hard, flaky feeling. This is the best. And when I spoke to my mom about this product, she definitely encouraged me and told me that this definitely makes your hair grow. So, two for one. Now, moving on to, I want to talk about this first. I love this product, and I've told you guys a lot about this product, like on my Instagram, and for anybody that just asks me in general, what is it I use on my hair, like when I have it curly and to get it that really nice curl? I normally, like I said, leave my hair to air dry. And sometimes if I want an afro nice curly look, I'll go in with the leave-in conditioning cream by Cantu. Guys, I'm telling you, Cantu products really stimulate the hair follicle and they restore the hair back to its natural texture. Like, I'm telling you, this product came so far. Like, they used to sell this in, well, they still do, in Dollar Tree. And this was like for girls that were like trying to keep up with their hair but on a budget. And I'm just so happy to see the company and the business like succeed. And just, I feel like they changed their formula a bit, you know, for us. So thank you to Cantu. And last, this is the last, I promise, the last thing I'm gonna talk about are these two awesome hair masks. Nah, don't kill me. I bought this because I thought the bottle was cute. I thought the packaging was just so adorable. I'm like, I could use this for like a scrub or lotion. I'm already plotting. But when I open it, it's a very thick consistency. I think I got this at Sally's. This is the Eva New York City Therapy Session Hair Mask. And let me tell you something. I use this. I think this is why my hair did not fall out through the process of me going blonde. And this is how much I love it. Like, when my hair is like not dirty, but when it's transitioning and getting to its dirty state after like a few days of it being straight, I like to go back in like with a little mask, but not so the hair is heavy and it feels like I can't style it because there's just so much product in it. I can't really say anything bad about this. It says it's with plant protein argan oil. It conditions, hydrates, and smooths, and it's for all hair types. So this is the Eva NYC Therapy Session Hair Mask. I think this was $15, $14. And last, I used this when I first went blonde, and I wish I knew about it first, because when I went blonde the first time, my hair was bad and I had to dye it back to brown. And that's when I found out about this guy, because if I would have known about it while my hair was damaged, this probably would have saved my hair. This is the best thing. And I used this, someone at Sally's recommended me the sample, so I tried it first and I saw that they had the bigger jar. So I said, you know what, I need this in my freaking bathroom because it smells amazing. Like, this reminds me of my childhood. It's It's called the Guacamole Whip Deep Moisture Hair Mask. It has avocado, argan oil, and monoi oil. It's free of sulfates and parabens. So it says avocado, but this smells like cucumbers. This smells like fresh sweetness on your hair. And I love it. Like, I can't stress these products enough. Like, well, everything I spoke about today in these videos, I hope you guys like check it out and find what works best for you. It was so nice sharing these products with you. It was so nice chatting. It's been such a long time. I really do hope that I can gain my subscribers back and people continue to watch my channel. I will try to be as active on my channel as much as possible. Just gotta bear with me, guys. So thank you so much, guys, for watching. And until next time, I'll see you later.